Durham with the very reachable target of 166 to win the Royal London One Day Cup final here at Lord's. But they didn't start well. In the very first over, Phil Mustard was gone for a duck. Clean bowled, Clark swinging one back. It then got worse as McLeod went in the third over. Shaky start to what should have been a comfortable run chase for Durham. Stoneman started nicely though, hitting four boundaries in the first four overs. He kept up the pace, hitting three fours in one Chris Wokes over. But troubles continued at the other end. Jennings was the next to go, trapped LBW by Patel. Durham still with plenty of time to spare though, but then the danger man was gone. Shortly after reaching 50, it was Stoneman's turn to succumb to the spin of Patel. But Durham still had control of this, Stokes imperious down the ground. Collingwood hit a couple of boundaries too before he was caught by Porterfield. 20 overs left, Durham required 46 runs, but Patel continued to cause real problems. A fourth LBW dismissal. Still very much in Durham's hands though, Stokes hitting boundaries and also riding his luck. It was set up for a fairy tale end as Gareth Breese, in his final game for Durham, hit the winning runs. Delight for Durham, disappointment for Warwickshire, who can't secure the domestic double. In truth, it was always going to be difficult to defend 165 runs, and Durham reached it with three wickets to spare. Stokes there at the end on 38 not out. Stoneman got Durham off to a solid start with a well-hit 52. Patel bowled superbly and certainly made it nervy for Durham, but it wasn't to be enough. It's Durham who are champions of the Royal London One Day Cup.